Have anybody here ever have, pardon the language, a shitty day? It just got, did you ever get up in the first thing in the morning, a bad email or a bad phone call or something happened and it was just Monday morning and it was like, oh God, you know, and the malaise sets in. How do you get past that?
You're not talking about vodka, no?
For me, I usually throw on some music and take a walk.
Music and exercise, two very good things. I love music. You want to have a bad day? Turn on some good music.
Right.
Okay. Not a Mozart funeral dirge. To put on something, you know, put on something hot. Dance around. Anybody dance around the house in their underwear ever? I'm the only one, right? It's a bad visual, isn't it?
The Tom Cruise visual.
Oh, the Tom Cruise visual. Risky Business.
Risky Business.
And who? And what was the song that was played in Risky Business when he's dancing in his underwear?
Bob Seger.
You know this stuff. I'm impressed. So
Chris, I got to go on a game show and make some money, huh?
I am dying to go on Jeopardy. I am so dying to go on Jeopardy. I love that show. You know, I miss Alex Trebek. I'm still in mourning. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. Chris, why is it important to fire the prospect, but sometimes make a decision? Can I go back? Is this a prospect who's just nervous, doesn't trust me yet? Is this a prospect who is totally, I'm going to just practice? Is this a prospect? Maybe I can bring them back in again by saying it's over. Did you know, hey, it's over. But now that it's over, Chris, can I ask you another question? It's not the money, is it?
Got to find the real problem.
The real problem? 99% of the time, what's the real problem?
Money.
It's money, baby. So what do you do if you know that, seriously, I would say 90%. Would everybody agree with that?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. If we know that 90% of the time it's money, it could be decision-making. Okay.
Could be time as well.
It could be a time. There's all little factors. Mostly it's money. So if you know it's money most of the time, and you say, now that it's over, use those words. Now that it's over, Chris, I'm going to take off my salesman hat. You take off your prospect hat. Let's just relax here for a second. Is that okay, buddy?
Yes.
Can I call you Chris, Mr. Scott? I'm Claude.
Yeah. Call me Chris.
Okay. See these moves? This is nurturing, stroking, little moves. Chris, now that it's over, you know, you called me up. We had a great conversation. You told me you're living in your brother-in-law's attic with the dog, with the five pit bulls and your new girlfriend, and you're dying to get into your own place. Boy, there's a bad visual there too.
Did the pit bulls eat the chihuahuas?
I want to give the chihuahuas a day off for this Monday. Chris, you told me you wanted your own place. You wanted peace and quiet, serenity. You wanted to cook your own food. You wanted the dogs to play in the backyard and attack the mailman once in a while. No, don't do that. And why aren't we doing business today? It's not the money, is it?
Yeah, Claude, I mean, you've been great and I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
It's the money. I mean, if...
It happens to everybody. Listen, money's tight right now. We've got inflation. Everybody's going through this. I've had money troubles too. I've had more month than money. Off the role play. What did I just
empathy.
Do? Empathy. What did I just do to make him feel good? What happens when you finally get that honesty in a conversation and that person reveals something personal? It's the money.
This guy feels me.
What is that person just revealed something that might be embarrassing? How do you save this person and make them feel good again? Because now they just put themselves down. That's not a good environment. We talked about environment earlier. Is environment, we got to create the right environment. So if they reveal something to us that might be embarrassing or personal, what you have to say is, how do you fix it?
Take the problem off the table.
How? Somebody besides David, tell me how.
Offering a solution.
What would it sound like? Oh, you know, Jessica, money's right. You know, we just paid our taxes and the dog had to go to the vet. And I'll be honest with you, money's really, I really want to do business and you've been great, but money's really tight right now.
That is what most people's biggest challenge is, I have to say. But the great news is that I don't usually do this, but I can offer you some private lending that I think could solve your problem.
Oh, that would be great. Yeah. Off the role play, give me a little, you get a B plus on that. Make it an A plus. I've had problems. I know a lot of my customers. Give me a little bit more sugar on that.
I'll share a secret with you. I started in my garage and I had no money and I was $30,000 in debt with my credit cards. And that's a true story, everybody. So I really know what it's like to be in that tight space and not know where you're going to go next.
Very good.
I think we can help you.
What happens when you share? Yeah, the little fiddle comes out. You have one. Why are you faking it? You have one. You have a violin there.
I put it away.
What happens when we show that we're human, that we've had the same experiences, that they are, do people beat themselves up sometimes? Oh, I should have saved. I shouldn't have bought the racehorse. I bought $2,000 in lottery tickets and I didn't win. What a shock. I mean, when they do that stuff, don't we have, and we rescue them. Mm. Does that give us a better sales,
where are you going?
A better place to sell?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely. So that's the rescue. So back to Chris, let's go through everything you learned here over the last 15 minutes here. We beat the firing the prospect is very important. Sometimes you have to, sometimes you can rescue them. Sometimes you want to leave the barn door open a little bit so they come back to you. Sometimes you put a time limit on. Chris, doesn't sound like we're going to do business today. I'm going to send you a little gift. And if you change your mind and call me before 6:30 today, my offer stays on the table to then. After that, it's over. So please don't call me Tuesday or Wednesday and say you changed your mind. It's over today. Okay. I only make this offer once. And I know it sounds like I'm trying to pressure you. I know how you feel, but I'm just too busy. I'm sorry. And I want to, but I'd love to do business with you before. Something like that.
I know that worked, Claude, because it worked on me.
It's just being human and understanding the emotions of humans, the psychology, I study this stuff every day. I read psychology books. I just listen. I'm an observer. I watch things in supermarkets and stores and airports. I study people. I want to know what makes some people tick and how do you turn a negative situation into a positive one? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Close me. 60 seconds. Go for it, Chris.
All right. I understand that.